Hello everyone, Sage here. Welcome to the Executive Corner Expert Talks 20-Minute Roundup. Today we have Ms. Jennifer Chow, the CEO and Managing Director of Chimeric Therapeutics. And Chimeric Therapeutics is developing cellular therapies through the combined efforts of a world-class team of cell therapy pioneers. And they are commercializing innovative and promising cell therapies, not just to delay cancer progression, but also to cure the disease. And in today's show, we have Ms. Jennifer Chow, the CEO and Managing Director at Chimeric Therapeutics, to share insights of the stock markets and how it can create the possibility of passive income streams for you. So welcome to the show, Jennifer. It's a pleasure in meeting you.
Thank you so much, Sage. It's great to be here today.
Well, I'm sure the viewers are keen to hear from you, so let's get started. A disease control rate of 75% was achieved in Chimeric's CLTX CAR-T phase 1 clinical trial at dose level 1. Plus, no dose limiting toxicity was observed. How do you think these encouraging results would catalyze the progress?
Sage, thank you for asking that question. That was data that we were obviously very excited about. So what we're talking about is our cortoxin CAR-T. And the patients that were treated in dose level 1, and that was 4 patients. So very early days and limited number of patients, but incredibly encouraging results. What we saw at that very, very low dose level was what you mentioned, a 75% disease control rate. So very positive and encouraging early data. And we saw that with no dose limiting toxicity, so generally a very well tolerated safety profile. So for us, we really see this as such an important first step. This again is very low dose of cells that were being given to these patients. So we're really, really seeing this as encouraging and promising as the trial continues to advance to the higher dose levels that we believe will offer the patients even more benefit.
Thank you.
I believe you have been patiently waiting for the trials to be able to continue after the pandemic restrictions. So it's great to hear you've got that underway. Thank you for sharing the results of your clinical trials. And Chimeric marked a significant milestone in the development of the CDH17 CAR-T with the recent manufacturing of CHM2101 research grade plasmids. We would like to know more about this development and the company's subsequent steps in this direction, if you could.
Message. So what you're talking about, CDH17 CAR-T, that is the second asset that we brought into our portfolio in July of this year from the University of Pennsylvania. And our plan with that asset, Sage, is to get that into clinic as soon as we can. We believe that asset has incredible promise for patients with gastrointestinal cancers. So the first thing that you need to do with any cell therapy, any CAR-T therapy, is really establish and work out your manufacturing. It's one of the biggest challenges in developing cell therapies. Our team was actually already thinking about the manufacturing and technical operations of this particular CAR-T back when we were actually doing diligence on licensing it. And so right away, when we were able to sign the license in July, we moved right into establishing all of the steps we need to be able to confirm our manufacturing and technical operations. So the announcement you were referring to, we were very pleased to be able to make so early on after the license and that we had in July. And that really just marked the very first step on the path to making sure all of our manufacturing and technical operations are ready to take that CAR-T into clinic next year.
That's fantastic.
And next year is really not that far away anymore.
Not anymore.
Well, best of luck moving forward on that. And how is Chimeric progressing its targeted drug therapies, and how is strategy better evolved than the traditional approaches currently being followed to fight cancer, please, Jennifer?
I think that's one of the things about cell therapy, Sage, is that when you think about cancer development, and I've been in it for a long time and worked on many different types of therapies, and generally or historically, the goal has really been to delay disease progression for patients. So the patients get cancer, and what we've been trying to do is sort of have it so that their disease goes away or doesn't progress for a period of time. So we're really looking to delay the disease from getting worse. One of the amazing things about cell therapies and CAR T therapies is the goal there is not so much disease progression as it is to actually cure cancer. So it's a much more ambitious goal than I think we've ever gone after in cancer development. And these particular types of therapies, cell therapies, they're what we call living drugs. And so they're really unique in their ability to be able to go after cancer and cure cancer, because when you put them into a patient's body, it's not just that they kind of come in and affect the patient at one moment in time. As living drugs, they actually stay in the body, and they have an ability to act on a patient's immune system, to actually boost the patient's immune system and stay there over a period of time. So they potentially can even work if a patient has their cancer start to come back. So these therapies, I think, are really unique. And I think what they do is they offer much better outcomes to patients than we've seen before.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. It's mind expanding hearing you talk about your projects. Last time we spoke, you were using a scorpion venom to heal a type of brain cancer. You were going to trial the ventricular modulation in order to test dose levels and toxicity. Would that be the first trial you mentioned in this interview?
Yes, Sage. So that is our cortoxin CAR T, which actually uses deathstalker scorpion venom. Right, and so that is the trial that we had those response rates, the 75% disease control on.
Well, congratulations, it's good to hear that's on track. And Chimeric Therapeutics continues to be actively engaged in developing its oncology pipeline. Would you shed light on how the company's funding its research initiatives, please?
Absolutely, Sage. So as of the end of September, the company had about $18 million in the bank, or just less than $18 million. So all of our activities currently are funded from existing cash reserves. And we're always very cognizant of being really good stewards with the investments and the funds that people have trusted with us with. So as we continue to move forward, we really just are continuing to advance and open our trials, bringing in new assets, and we'll continue to really manage our finances and very carefully as we do so.
Fantastic to hear. Your company is working with some of the leading CAR T innovators. How do you plan to accelerate the development of improved CAR T approaches?
Yeah, and you know what? You said it exactly. It's the people, Sage. It's who you're working with, right? And I think that is where we have been so successful. So two pieces, I think, really go into that. One is the people that we have been able to bring into Chimeric as part of our management team. Everybody has extensive experience in developing cell therapies, was right there pioneering them in their very early days. And so that's given us a lot of insight and experience on how to develop them. It's also given us all great networks that we're able to tap into anytime we want to understand more information on a question or what's going on recently. We have great networks to do that. So one way I think Sage has been through our own people. The other way is through the incredible collaborators we have. And so at City of Hope with the cortoxin CAR T, Drs. Christine Brown and Michael Barish as the inventors, we have a great collaboration with them and are able to really tap into their knowledge and insights. And similarly, the University of Pennsylvania team and Dr. Waugh, who invented our CDH17 CAR T, our collaboration with him allows us to gain additional insight. So I think that it really is through the people.
Well, it's plain to see that the dedication and selflessness from the people in the medical industry is so commendable. I hope interviews like this offer a chance for the public to hear about and appreciate what you do. Thanks for sharing with us. Chimeric announced a new asset this week. Could you tell us about this exciting update, please?
I would be thrilled to tell you about that exciting update, Sage, because we were absolutely delighted to be able to announce that we had the exclusive option to the Core NK platform. And Sage, what that is it is an NK or natural killer cell platform technology. And what that means essentially is that it is a platform of NK cells that have been engineered that we can now use to make multiple new therapies from. And so right away, we're planning to develop actually four additional new chimeric therapies using our core NK platform. And then we're also going to continue to look for other opportunities for collaborations and other licensing opportunities to continue to leverage that platform. So incredible science that went into it, very cutting edge to be using natural killer cells and to be able to move into developing CAR NK products. And I think it is just something that we believe is transformative for us as a company, because it certainly takes us to a place where we're able to add multiple new assets very rapidly. So lots of excitement about that announcement.
Thank you.
Well, that sounds amazing. Thanks for sharing the passion you have for your projects that you oversee with us today and fitting us in amidst your busy schedule. We do appreciate your insights. So where do you see yourself in the next 12 months?
Yeah, Sage, within the next 12 months, so by this time next year, we anticipate that we will actually have three phase one clinical trials. Right now we have the one. We will have a second phase one clinical trial for our CDH, our chlorotoxin CAR T, and then we'll also have our CDH17 CAR T opening in a phase one clinical trial next year as well. So we'll have three clinical trials, and then we'll be, you know, progressing four more with the new NK cell platform and the CAR NKs we're looking to develop it. So four trials almost, you know, ready to open that we're planning to open in 2023. So lots of activity for clinical development and really moving all of the assets that we have now into those very important clinical trials.
That was a fabulous show. It was lovely chatting with you, Jennifer, and we thank you for your time.
Thank you so much, Sage. It was a pleasure to see you again.
And with that, Sage here will sign off for today. Watch this space for more. Until then, stay apprised and invest wise with Kalkine.